Anticipation at the track. Speed at every turn. The crowd, the thrill, the win. This is Harness Racing. Hello everyone, I'm Gary Seibel, and welcome to Trotters and Pacers, stories of harness racing. You know, on most days at harness tracks like this one, it's pretty quiet. But at night, when the action heats up, this place is all abuzz, and these seats are filled. On today's show, we're going to talk about one of the most prestigious events in the sport, the Breeders' Crown, held at the Meadowlands Racetrack in New Jersey. It's harness racing's year-end divisional championship forum, where all horses, trotters and pacers, can compete successfully, whether they're perennial champions or first-time stakes starters. So come and join us on the show today as we explore the owners, trainers, drivers, and horses that make the Breeders' Crown what it is, an esteemed event featuring the best of the best. And why? The history, the pageantry, the thrill that makes the Breeders' Crown so special in the eyes of so many. Next, the story of Steve Elliott, the highly successful trainer who shares his feelings on racing, standardbreds, and the study of the horse. Donato Hanover, and his amazing run in 2007. Of course, this story shows you that you don't have to be in Barreto, a special little boy, and the bond between the standardbred owner and the boy whose legacy lives on in the heart of a very special horse. This story shows you that you don't have to be in the winner's circle to be considered a champion. Finally, we talk with Ray Schnitger about his incredible horse, Dewey Cheatham and Howe. The combination of Dewey's heart and Ray's unique training techniques create a horse with unmatched talent, potential, and championship aspirations. The Breeders' Crown is the premier competition for standardbreds, offering millions of dollars in purse money covering the Crown's 8 events. The Hambletonian Society created the Breeders' Crown to promote awareness of the sport and also to award the sport's top performers, owners, trainers, drivers, and horses. And more than likely, the Breeders' Crown will decide year-end divisional honors in the standardbred sport. The Goliaths of the sport enter the Breeders' Crown envisioning victory. But over the years, fame and fortune have come to the small breeders, the one-horse owners, the trotters and pacers that played David to those Goliaths in major upsets. In the inaugural year, 1984, upstart Dragon's Lair beat the heavy favorite Nihilator in world record time. This established the Breeders' Crown as the classic confrontation between those expecting to be champions and those aspiring to greatness. Low point in that career until a horse came along by the name Rear in Harness Racing. He was at a low point in that career until a horse came along by the name of Donato Hanover. Win after win after win marked the 2007 campaign of Donato Hanover, including a Hambletonian victory, and a Breeders' Crown win seemed certain to follow. But Arch Madness had other ideas and defeated Donato Hanover not once, but twice in the Breeders' Crown, in both the elimination and the final. Despite those Breeders' Crown losses, Donato Hanover was voted 2007 Horse of the Year, and Steve Elliott became Trainer of the Year. We sat down with Steve Elliott and got his take on the life of a standardbred trainer, winning the Hambletonian, losing the Breeders' Crown, and training a Horse of the Year.
Anytime any young person gets around horses, they fall in love. And once I think it gets in your system, you can't get it out. And I got bit by the bug, and I went from cars to horses. So I grew up in Detroit, and you know, I love racing cars and mess with car engines. And once I got with the horses, I forgot all about the cars. And it's been special ever since. When you win a race, there's nothing like it. I mean, your heart starts pumping, you know, when they're coming down the lane, and it's hard to explain that feeling to anybody. And I couldn't explain the feeling I got when we won the Hambo. It was like, your emotions just take over, and there's nothing, you can't control them. It was just joy, you know, and it's a feeling you wish everybody could experience once in their lifetime, because it's unbelievable. Donato was special from the day he came in the barn. I mean, just carried himself different, I guess you would say. He wanted to do everything right. He was very willing, but not aggressive, and was 2-year-old a year. His whole schedule was mapped out before he ever races a 2-year-old to be a Hambo horse. And we aim for that one day in August. It's probably the most prestigious race you can win in our business. And just to race in it is special, let alone be lucky enough to win it. And got very fortunate, and he raced very good on Hambo day and won the final. So then there was talk of the world record. And we went to DuQuoyne. The track was a little bit hard. We were more concerned with winning the racing, special in the racing, be lucky in the racing, and got in the racing, very good in the racing, they won the final. So then they went to DuQuoyne.